Hello, my beautiful ladies. It's Greta here, Ladies Relationship Coach. And today, my beauties, the video for you is 5 ways on how you might be pursuing him totally unintentionally. Well, the reason I decided to make this topic is because when I do my one-on-one coaching with my girls, and they break down for me their relationship. They say like, oh, but Greta, I never chase him. He's always texting me. He's always calling me. And then we break it down deeper and I'm like, ooh, but you are pursuing him here, you're pursuing him here, you're chasing him here, you're wearing your heart on a sleeve here, you're trying to impress him here. I'm like, hon, you are pursuing him 80% of the time. So what that you don't call or text him first? And they're like, oh my God, how? I thought pursuing is just calling and texting. No, girls, it's not just calling and texting. So make sure to watch this video till the end, not to make those mistakes like the girls who come to me do. It's the first way on how you might be pursuing him is through calling and texting. It's the most obvious one. I think every single dating coach on this earth is telling this to the girls repeatedly. Do not call too much. Do not text too much. Right? Let the man pursue you. Let the man chase you. Let the man do the work. But ladies, be receptive. Alright, I know everybody knows, don't call him, don't text him, let him chase you. It's like literally in every single YouTube video that I watch. But ladies, the key is when you're letting a man pursue you, he's already doing the work. So your job as a lady is be receptive. Alright, don't overdo it. Try not to be too bitchy. Many girls go from too nice, too sweet to totally cold ice queen bitch. So this will turn guys off. You're gonna be like, oh, you're not appreciative of this. You're not into me. Or when I'm giving you something, you don't even say thank you. You don't appreciate it. You just go like, yeah, whatever. It should be this way anyway. And the other girl goes like, oh my God, you're the first guy who has ever done it to me. I love you so much. And we get like totally addicted to him. So girls, don't be like this, because if you don't appreciate at what he gives, he's just gonna stop giving it. And don't be like this, because you just look really sad and pretty pathetic. Alright, so both of these are turnoffs. You must be in between, in the middle, and being yourself, but being high value. Because another thing, girls ask me to create the text messages for them. It doesn't work, because if you're asking me, I will create my own text messages as how I am. All right, yes, we will be high value, but it's going to be me, myself. So ladies, when you are responding to a man, when you're having conversations with a man, you have to be yourself. You have to be your unique self, and you have to be confident with it, but at the same time, high value with it too. So the second way on how you might be unintentionally pursuing a man is with affection or sex, right? So I know many women who try and seduce him, try and touch a guy, buy him sexy lingerie, jump out of that cake, you know, all of that. Ladies, it does not work in the reality. The man is the chaser, he's the pursuer, he needs to impress you so you would like him. When the guy is chasing you and when he is giving you safety, do you girls like that? Do you girls just think like, oh my God, I met the one, he's so amazing, I feel so good? Yeah, that's how you feel, right? When you're giving this safety and pursuing a man, doing the pole dancing, when giving him lots of affection, attention, treating him like the princess, because this is what you're doing when you're pursuing a man, you are treating him like the princess, not like a king, not like a prince, like a princess. Right? Because you are the pursuer, so he's the princess now. So do you think your man enjoys being the princess when you are pursuing him with affection, trying to impress him, you know, like doing the pole dancing, pursuing him for sex? I don't think men love being the princesses. right? It's nice sometimes, it strokes their ego, but ego stroke and having their needs fulfilled, it's a different thing. You might want something, right? But you don't know, do you actually need it and is it good for you? So ladies, let men come after you with affection, sex, and the whole thing. It's so much nicer when he has to chase you to get you rather than you chasing him and he's like, oh, fine. Where is the hotness in that? It's not hot, it's a turn off. The third way on how you might be unintentionally pursuing him, oh, this is killing me so much, taking him on holidays. And this is happening so much, trying to impress the guy or trying to seduce the guy or trying to make the guy into the boyfriend. What girls started doing, they started taking men on holidays and paying for the whole trip. Oh my God, I have a story. So I remember this guy shared with me, he said, oh yeah, so I'm dating this girl and I suppose she likes spending time with me because she just took me for like 2 weeks of holiday totally free. And the guy is not a poor guy. The guy is actually pretty well set off. And for him, that was the biggest ego stroke. He's like, I had to do nothing. She just like likes me so much. She wants to impress me so much that she took me on holiday for those 2 weeks. Like literally, girls, the arrogance in his voice was like up to the sky, right? Does he care about that girl? Hell no. Ladies, do not try and impress men by taking them on holiday, by buying them expensive gifts, by giving. If anything, you will turn a guy off. The low value man will be like, okay, if she's giving it to me, I'll take it. I don't have feelings for her, but yeah, that's nice. I'll use it. You know, I'll go on that holiday free. My ego gets stroke. High value guy will get totally turned off. Ladies, if that guy is high value and he likes a woman to be a woman and he likes to be the pursuer, then you will start buying him gifts, then you will start taking him on holiday, he's gonna get totally turned off and he will dump you in no time. Because you're the one pursuing him. You're the one being the prince and you're making him into the princess. The high value guy cannot stand being a princess. Like damages you, like manly stuff, you know? The fourth way on how you might be unknowingly pursuing a man is sharing your feelings with him first. Telling him, I love you first. Ladies, I know we technically kind of get in touch with our feelings and emotions quicker than men do because we are just like, we always in touch with our emotions and feelings. This is how we are designed. But it does not benefit you in any way by sharing it with him first. If anything, you become the opposite of a challenge. If you feel like you're falling in love with a guy, keep it to yourself. When you're behaving high value, eventually he will fall in love with you. You know, let him say, I love you first. Let him open up his feelings to you first without pressurizing him for it, without asking him, how do you feel about me and so on. Just enjoy the moment, have fun. Let him come to you with his feelings first. When he comes to you with his feelings first, then you can say, I love you too. Feels a million times nicer when your guy does it first. You'll feel feminine, you'll feel like a princess instead of feeling like a prince, okay? The fifth way on how you might be pursuing him unintentionally is introducing him to the family and friends first. Ladies, let a man do that. A guy who is taking you seriously, he will introduce you to the family and friends. he's not gonna introduce a girl to the family and friends who he's just taking casually, or he's just sleeping with her, or you know, for most like kind of one night hookups. If he's introducing you to family and friends, he is taking you quite seriously. When he is introducing you to family and friends, he is giving you safety and it's making you feel good. But when you ladies do that, you are telling him that, look, I'm introducing you to my family and friends, therefore I'm taking this relationship seriously. So you doing it first, you're actually putting the pressure on him and you are pursuing him and you are giving him safety. Safety is not his love need, uncertainty is. So let a man do this first. And when he does introduce you to his family and friends first, then you can think about it. Are you ready to introduce him to your family and friends as well? Right? This way, again, you are behaving like the princess and you are letting him be the king, the prince, the pursuer, which is his need. All right? Ladies, another thing. What a man tells that he wants and what he needs to fall in love with you, these can be totally different things. So if you liked this video, please press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel, let me know in the comments below what do you think. Please let me just tell you one more thing. Listening to my advice, look at it as me giving you the knowledge, and then you need to pick and choose what you can apply to your specific guy, to your specific relationship. This is where the one-on-one coaching come in, right? When the girls come to me, I don't give them just the most general advice. They tell me their situation, they tell me about their guy, what kind of guy he is. And then we apply it step by step, gently on the type of guy that he is. Okay, ladies, join my Facebook group, High Value Women, where we are all in the same boat learning how to be a woman of high value and bring out the best in our men. It's private, ladies only. The group is phenomenal, where girls are helping each other out and supporting one another based on my advice. Follow me on my Instagram. My Instagram is called Ladies Relationship Coach. I do my Instagram lives 2 times a week, answering your dating and relationship questions during the lives. And if you would like me to hold your hand and help you to bring out the best in your man, you can always book me through my website, which is called ladiesrelationshipcoach.com, and choose the package which is right for you. Thank you so much for watching, beautiful girls. Have a lovely day. Kisses from London. Mwah.